name.
Amen. Amen.
Father, we bless you.
Amen.
We honor your name this morning. We say, Lord, our praise and our worship in your presence this morning, let them be acceptable to you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, without a shadow of doubt, we know you are already here with us. Because, Lord, you directed our path to be in your presence this morning. So I pray, Lord, the reason for our presence here, Father in heaven, make it clear to us.
Amen.
How will you make it clear to us? You will make it clear to us by touching every life here.
Amen.
You will touch destinies here today.
Amen.
Father, there will be realignment today.
Amen.
There will be rearrangement today.
Amen.
Powers will change hands.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Forces of darkness will be defeated
today. Amen.
Lord, people, your children shall be empowered today.
Amen.
They will begin to make great expressions.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Father in heaven, you will roll away sorrow.
Amen.
You will roll away tears.
Amen.
Father, there will be joy today.
Amen.
There will be fulfillment today.
Amen.
There will be victories today.
Amen.
There will be success today.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. As many as have entered into this tabernacle today, I pray for you. From today and every day of your life, you will make extraordinary
exploits.
Amen. I say, children of God, from now onwards, unbelievable blessings will accompany you. Maybe you did not hear that properly. I say that which has not ever come to the understanding of man before, that which no ears have heard before, that which no eyes have seen before,
oh yeah,
receive it in the name of Jesus Christ. I say, I declare over your lives, from today, no one hinders you anymore. I say from today and all the days of your life, your joy will overflow.
Amen.
Your joy will overflow.
Amen.
Your joy will overflow.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Father, send your word to us today.
Amen.
You are the word.
Yes.
Father, speak to us.
Amen.
Touch every situation
Amen.
In our lives.
Amen.
Lord, you yourself is the one I'm asking to minister unto your people today.
Amen.
And as they hear your words, let there be transformation.
Amen.
Let there be turnaround.
Amen.
In the lives of your children, Father, let your word take away stagnation.
Amen.
Let your word take away failure.
Amen.
Let your word take away pain.
Amen.
Let it take away agony.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Father, we feel your presence. But there is a higher plane of seeing you. As many as will say Amen. From today onwards, you will see God.
Amen.
But one is even greater. For God himself to see his own children. So I pray for you. Through his word today, God will see you.
Amen.
He will recognize you.
Amen.
He will decorate your
Amen.
Life. In the name of Jesus
Christ.
Father, come with us.
Amen.
I reduce flesh to nothingness. And I ask that your spirit be lifted up.
Amen.
Your spirit in me, let it be lifted up.
Amen.
Father, speak your undiluted word.
Amen.
At the end of it all, Let all honor, let all glory, let all adoration be unto you. And let all the blessings be unto your children. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I know, as I always say, my tomorrow is very secure. You know how I know? Because God has just confirmed it. See my son behind the camera.
Hallelujah.
He came into the house of God and he looked for where he can be useful. Your destiny will not be contaminated.
Amen.
Your destiny will not be contaminated.
Amen.
I say I know that my tomorrow is very secure.
Amen.
It's very safe.
Amen.
I want you to lift up your voice. The seed that the Lord has given you, every child in this church, just pray, begin to bless them and prophesy into their lives. That's our tomorrow. That's our tomorrow. I know each and every one of them. Nobody shall trouble their destinies. Pray for each and every one of our children. One of our sons will be 21 tomorrow. Pray. 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 Grace is in the house today. Let God release His grace upon each and every one of them. Bless the name of the Lord for their lives. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. The Lord asked me to tell somebody. He reminded me of one thing that happened to me just yesterday. You see, I really had no time to prepare for this journey I'm going on. So I went online and I saw Sports Direct, whatever. I don't know how they got my email address. They've been sending me all sorts of emails. So I just looked at them. They said they are doing clearance on t-shirts and whatever. £1, £125, £175. I said, I now remember, this is what I need. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So I went online. I'm computer literate. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I told you because it was me that brought internet to London.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Okay. The day that I arrived in this nation, that was the day they launched internet. Go and make inquiries, August 6, 1991.
Hallelujah.
I don't become old cargo for London.
Hallelujah.
Immediately, they sent me an email. The order has been received. I said, fine. They put three things. Received, processed, collected. They will allow me. The following day, the order has been processed. So the third day, I was expecting that the order has been collected. No, by the courier, whatever company that will now bring it. Because I said I may not be at home. So I said, don't deliver at home. I will collect at Sports Direct in Charlton. I now waited for order to be collected. No email. Order. Wednesday, nothing. Thursday, nothing. Friday, nothing. I cannot get nothing planned to where I'm going. When I go, my jeans are ready, no trouble. But so yesterday morning, I now determined. I said, that Sports Direct is me and them. I went there. I printed out the first letter, the first email they sent, so I took it with me. I said, check this. They now checked on the system. The thing was already there. So they entered and brought it out. In fact, I didn't believe at first. But when they brought it out, I said, sure, so this thing, you've been waiting here, and you didn't want me to come and collect. I collected it yesterday. And God is using that same incident to say to somebody right here, he said, what you have been asking for has already been released. Whatsoever you are asking of the Lord, receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it in the name of Jesus. So all I want to ask, I don't know if there's anybody in this house who is tired of crawling. Me, I'm tired of crawling. I want to begin to fly. Where I tell God, I am tired of crawling. No, I am tired of sorry you are. No, how unfortunate you. No. Oh, yeah, talk to the Lord. When it comes to me and my household, we are totally tired of crawling. Yes. Empower me, O Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Write it down, child of God. God is saying to me that for somebody here, and I'm believing God for every one of us here, this month of April will be a very special month.
Amen.
It shall be a month for special breakthroughs.
Amen.
It shall be a month for ridiculous blessings. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whatever you desire for the month of April, don't you? I want to preach. I cannot just ignore the word of God coming through. Mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Say it is well with me.
It is well with me.
No, say it is well with me.
It is well with me.
Wow. Say it is well with me.
It is well with me.
It is well with you all.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
You may be seated. God says he will anoint somebody very specially today.
Amen.
And you will begin to flourish.
Amen.
Say, I will begin to flourish.
Hallelujah.
And for somebody, he says, garment of shame has left you.
Hallelujah.
You shall never wear it again.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Somebody will shed tears of joy.
Amen.
This very month of April, you will shed tears of joy.
Amen.
You know, know there are certain things that are beyond description. That shall be your portion in Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Just pardon me, I want to preach, but I have to give way if the Lord is talking. Nobody can force him to speak. But once he speaks, you must give way. Because whatever he says, certainly it will come to pass. Certainly it will come to pass. This month, you will be fruitful.
Amen.
The story of Hannah. It's a very familiar story to us. And I bless God. I know we know the details of the story. For as the Lord was giving me the word for today, I was wondering, what other thing can come out of this story of Hannah? Our mothers, God bless you all. God bless you all. Because even from biblical times, God has been using the lives of his daughters, you know, to be a blessing unto us all. The plan of our discussions at the NAB video was based on Esther. And God revealed a totally different aspect of the life of Esther unto us on Friday. And I'm believing God that today, Hannah's one too will not be different.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
Say to your neighbor, God bless you.
God bless you.
God bless you.
God bless you.
So let us start from this. Hannah, the initial story of her life was one of frustration, of disappointment, of hopelessness, of despair. So now, if you now look at that kind of a person, and a human being comes and says, I can help you, it is not a matter that any human being can help. Only God could have helped her. So what are we talking about today? The theme of our message is reinventing the best in you. Reinventing the best in you. Who can reinvent the best in you? It's only God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God reinvented the best in Hannah. Just as you and I, one prayer earlier, I don't want to crawl anymore, I want to fly. But on your way up, there will be challenges. There will be those who don't want you to get there. There will be those who want you to begin to doubt God. There will be God, the people who want to say, listen, there is nobody, people like you, no, you are not on the list. But he said, because God has qualified you, nobody can reduce your
Amen.
Glory.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In verse 8, Elkanah, her husband, will say to her, Hannah, why are you weeping? Why don't you eat? Why are you downhearted? Don't I mean more to you than 10 sons? Ordinarily, she could have said, well, that's fine. But you see, there was dissatisfaction in her heart. The divine hunger of the heart. When you are hungry in your heart, it is an indication, child of God, that God is leading you to somewhere greater. You will not settle for less.
Amen.
God created us for a purpose and with a purpose. And he wants us to reach that goal. So the craving of our heart surely must be an indication that there is somewhere greater than where we are. I said to you, there is more in you.
Amen.
Say to your neighbor, there is more in you.
There is more in you.
There is more to you than
where you are.
You must move forward.
You will move forward.
I pray for you, you will move forward. I connect with your destiny. You will move forward.
You will move forward.
You will move forward.
You will move upward.
You will never go down.
You will never fail.
In the name of Jesus. There's something greater than where you are. Hannah could have, she could have died as an unfruitful bow. I don't know how beautiful Hannah was, but she must have been very beautiful. But with all the beauty, she was not fruitful.
Your own life, people may see it and say, yes,
very beautiful. She has money, she's comfortable, he's lovely, he's handsome. By the way, someone saw me this morning and he said, Daddy, the person is smiling. I said, you've never seen this young boy before. You've not seen this young boy before. By the way, it was my birthday yesterday. Nobody knew. I was 14 years old yesterday. Hallelujah. Me, I'm growing younger and younger. I'm growing younger and younger. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, you will never die young. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm happy. Children of God, I am happy. And I see the angels of God surrounding us here. They are just dancing. They are just rejoicing. They are just showering us with bestows. I am happy because I know God is happy with us. God bless you.
Amen.
Say to your neighbor, God bless you.
God bless you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You will accomplish God's purpose for your life.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Children of God, this is where we're coming. As a child of God, you must be fruitful. You may be serving God, coming to church, but you must be spiritually filled. If we are not spiritually filled, the enemies will penetrate into our lives. They will examine your life. And if there's any stain, just a little stain, that is what Satan needs. He doesn't need a big one. If there's a single stain, he will use it to challenge you. He will say to you, who is this one talking? We know each other now. Is it not you? I know where I saw you last night now. Now you are holy, holy, holy. I beg, shut up. That is the way of Satan. But if he comes and examines you and he says, this one is on fire, there is no way I can come near this one because he knows he will be destroyed. I say every plan of the enemy concerning your life, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
In the name of the God of Abraham.
Amen.
In the name of God of Isaac.
Amen.
In the name of God of Jacob.
Amen.
God of Elijah.
Amen.
God of Elisha.
Amen.
He will destroy them.
Amen.
He will put them to shame. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You may be safe. What about your friend? What about the company that you keep? You may be saved. God's first command to mankind is to be fruitful and multiply. I may be preaching, or if I have a single debt in my life, it will not carry any weight. Before God, it will just be like a noise. No matter the prayer, no matter the speaking in tongue and dancing in tongue, you will just be nothing. But that shall not be abortion in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God wants us to attain the fullness of our destiny. He wants the best for you and me. He does not want second best for his children. But the question is, are you prepared to venture for more on God? Or are you already settled for something less? God will advertise
me. Amen.
Say, God will advertise me. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The fourth lesson I want us to take from this is from verse 10 to 16. We see a prayer of desperation. You see, the end of our own physical strength, it can turn out to be the turning point to discover the power and the might of God. Verse 10, he says, in bitterness of soul, Hannah wept much and prayed to the Lord. You know, praying is like birthing a child. Hannah gave birth to Samuel first in prayer before the baby Samuel became a reality. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So when you pray and you believe, when you pray, you are saying, I'm dependent totally on you. I have no power of my own. There's no other authority that I respect or regard except you. There is no authority that God cannot command to change.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Whatever help you need, today God will give you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say God will give you.
Amen.
You see, Penina, she may have had many children, but they cannot be compared to even Samuel alone. Samuel happened to be one of the greatest prophets in the Old Testament. And she was born by Hannah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Your children will make you great.
Amen.
And they will be greater than you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. None of your children will be a disappointment.
Amen.
They will not disappoint you.
Amen.
They will not disappoint God.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Verses 17 and 18. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Eli answered, go in peace, and may the God of Israel grant you and what you have asked of him. I say the same to you. From today, turbulence come to an end.
Yeah.
I say from today, difficulties come to an end.
Yeah.
From today, struggle come to an end.
Yeah.
So go in peace. The Lord will grant all your heart desires. In the name of Jesus Christ. Verse 18, she said, may your servant find favor in your eyes. Then she went her way and ate something, and her face was no longer downcast. What is that? Word of declaration. All we need to do is to hear God's promise and declare it. As you hear it from the servant of God, and you begin to dwell in it and delve in it and take over that word that comes. You claim it by faith. I sent something onto our WhatsApp group this morning. It shall be unto you.
Amen.
According to your faith.
Amen.
Because you believe God and you have come into his presence right now, I don't know what spectacular thing you want from me. As the Spirit of the Lord is leading me right now, if you believe, I am saying to you, before the end of this week, whatever you ask right now, you will receive it.
Amen.
Oh yeah, ask of the Lord. it by Anna. She claimed it by faith and she began to rejoice. She said, now I can eat, and she went to eat. And she was no longer downcast. I stand this morning as the servant of the Most High God, and I declare upon each and every life here today, you become a recipient of endless divine blessings. In the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You must be a fruitful book, bringing many souls to Christ. You will have increase in blessing.
Amen.
You will have increase in faith.
Amen.
You will not be stagnant.
Amen.
I say your progress shall be rapid.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. We are coming somewhere right now. I just want to quickly conclude. But the sixth lesson I want us to look at is verse 19. Early the next morning, they arose and worshipped before the Lord, and then went back to their home at Ramah. Elkanah lay with Hannah his wife, and the Lord remembered her. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I say to you, worship is the button that is pressed for God to release his blessings upon his children. So they worship the Lord. And as they worship the Lord, that very night, what Hannah had been praying for, year in, year out, it came to pass. They worship God, and God remembered Hannah. Life comes from God. And so, children of God, we must worship him in all that we are doing. Worship and prayers touch the heart of God. God will remember you.
Amen.
God will remember you.
Amen.
Let us rise for the next 1 or 2 minutes. Let's worship the Lord. Let's worship the Lord. Let's worship the Lord. Worship the Most High God. He is worthy. He's worthy, so magnify his name. He's the I am that I am. The ancient of days. The beginning, the ending. The King of kings. The Lord of lords. Let your name be glorified forever. Father, do the impossible for me. Oh Lord, that which they say is impossible. Father, do it for me. Lord, remember my presence. Remember that I am here in your presence today. Remember, Father, that which they say is impossible, do it for me. Do it for me. Yes, that which they have been oppressing me over, that they have been, they've been mocking me over, Father, do it for me. Do it for me. Yes. Yes. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Now lift up your individual request unto the Lord. Lift up your individual request unto the Lord. I am believing God. He will do it. I am believing God. Reinventing the best in you. He is reinventing the best. Not just the good, not just the better, but the best. He can use anything. You may think you are between the mountain and the rock and the hard place. But no, he can use that even and turn it to fertile ground in your life. That is what I want you to understand. Go before the Lord and say that which they say is impossible. Make it a walkover for me. Make it a walkover for me. Yes. 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 In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Let's begin to thank the Lord for answered prayers. Let's thank the Lord for answered prayers. Say, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. Father, I thank you. Glory be to your holy name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Say, I'm moving forward.
I'm moving forward.
Say it as if you believe.
I'm moving forward.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Before I pray, I want to inform us that you can get, if you have not brought or written out your prayer request, there are sheets of paper with the usher and envelope to give you. I don't know, do you have pen? Ushers, do you have pen? Because I have a bit here too. So please write them out. You don't need to put your name. God knows. God knows. You understand? Don't even bother to put your name. Doesn't matter. But write out your prayer request. And I'm believing God. Please, I also want to encourage you. Don't say because I won't be here. I'm not going on a jamboree. We must be connected.
Yes.
You know, when you connect, then the power of God comes quicker.
Yes.
It works faster. It makes me a lot more happier. Yes. It makes the work a lot easier. You understand? Together we will enjoy God.
Amen.
Together we will enjoy God.
Amen.
Brother Henry, I see you. God bless you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let us pray. King of Kings, Lord of Lords. Again, we want to thank you for your word. We thank you, Father in heaven, for that which you have sent down unto us. Thank you for all the barricades that you have removed. Thank you for all the evil walls that you have brought down. Thank you, Father, for the new territory that you are taking your children. Thank you for elevation. Thank you for promotion. Thank you for joy. Thank you for comfort. Thank you for victory. Thank you, Father in heaven, for provision. Thank you for protection. Thank you, everlasting Father. We give you glory. We give you glory. Father, we thank you for all the impossibilities that you have destroyed. Father, we thank you for the conversion from impossibility to possibility. Father, we just appreciate you. Accept our thanks in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, you proved yourself in the life of Hannah. Father, in the lives of your children, Lord, prove yourself. More than ever before, prove yourself in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, I pray concerning your children, O Lord, let your grace be upon them. I say from today, everywhere that you go, you will be preferred.
Amen.
You will be celebrated.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. You will not be humiliated.
Amen.
You will not be intimidated.
Amen.
You will not be harassed.
Amen.
You shall never be shortchanged.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that the Spirit of the living God shall dwell with you. So in your goings out, I soak in the blood of Jesus. In your comings in, I soak in the blood of Jesus. Everywhere that you go, heavens will announce it. In the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord himself will take charge of the affairs of your life. Where they have said no before, from today, as you knock that door again, it will open unto you. For the throne of God, doors will open unto you. Doors of blessings will open unto you. Doors of glory will open unto you. Doors of honor will open unto you. And most importantly, the courage to walk through that door, the Lord will grant you. In the name of Jesus. So Father, I hand your children over unto you. In all the situations of their lives, Father, have your will.
Amen.
And let your will be done.
Amen.
In the morning, the Lord will bless you.
Amen.
In the afternoons, he will bless you.
Amen.
I say in the evenings, he will bless you.
Amen.
You shall not be alone.
Amen.
The Lord will surround you with his angels.
Amen.
They will minister his goodness unto you.
Amen.
Angels of God will minister his mercy unto you.
Amen.
Angels of God will minister his favor unto you. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So Father, we just thank you. We bless you.
Hallelujah.
We give you glory.
Hallelujah.
This week, O Lord, let there be no doubtless. There will be no trouble.
Amen.
In your home shall be peaceful.
Amen.
Your life shall be blissful.
Amen.
We have moved forward.
Amen.
From now, move forward.
Amen.
I say from now move forward.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord that surpasses all human understanding. Receive it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you,
in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Yeah.